so nice we decided to do it twice. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to DCA Redemption 2020 Night 2, live from Sin City.
You know what they say, what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas.
I am downtown Jason Brown here with Rick C and Chase Arthur here at the booth.
And hello, good to everyone. Be back.
And tonight we are prepared for more violence.
Yes, the most violent night in DCA history returns once again. And after how last night ended, we're in for more.
Yeah, I kind of left a little early.
I don't blame you. I don't blame you at all.
After what we saw and everything, what the fuck? But anyway,
well,
can we get a card out in the from the booth?
Production truck,
please. So we know what is on deck first. Pretty please.
Well, if we don't get a card here in a moment,
fuck it, we'll do it live. Anyways.
We'll do it live. Fuck it. You gotta do what you gotta do in these trying times.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
As I think up first...
We are going to have... The Takeru match. Yukimura is looking to return here tonight.
This is his return match to the Destiny Championship Alliance.
Yep, we haven't seen him since that night he lost the DCA World Title to Claudio Dragonheart.
The champion who we will see in the main event fighting Zack Stone.
And here he comes, the Rowan himself, Takeru Yukimura.
Do we know his opponent by any chance?
From what I can tell, a debut, KENZO. There he is, the Ronin himself, Takeru Yukimura. The man at the start of the season who was on top of the world. Now, he's hit rock bottom a little bit.
Ever since he lost the world title, he went AWOL, and only now is Takeru Yukimura coming back.
Now we await his opponent.
Oh.
Joe!
Here he is, the debuting KENZO. But anyways, I actually got a card here. We got Toshimi taking on Sakura Hagiwara. Amy Lam versus Akira. Kenshin versus Malik. The Wildcats tag team title will be on the line. Revy versus Roberta, and of course the Wildcats and DCA Takedown Major Championships will be on the line. So
we got a stack night too for you.
Big stack.
Big stack, big thick.
And KENZO, a guy who is known as the face of a company known as the VWA.
Oh.
Now making his
DCA debut against the returning
Takeru Yukimura.
This should be a match.
This is going to be it's very, I would say, almost similar styles a bit. Both men, you know, with that, you know, heritage they have, both Japanese individuals. Now that, you know that honor, Takeru has since left his honor behind him. Though, if we were to believe Claudio, Claudio might have beat the honor back into him.
Well, I hope that's the case, as we got the tie-up here. These two trying to wager for control here. As Kenzo starts to back up Takeru, setting him off the ropes here. Ducks down. Oh!
Now here's one of the interesting things. Before Claudio took Takeru down in that match, remember what Takeru shouted out. I can't lose. I have to do it for her.
Mm-hmm.
And who was that? Who was that her that he was referring to?
Akira?
Yep.
Oh!
But ever since her return and everything, we really haven't heard too much from Takeru. I mean, Suzumi, I mean, her and Akira, you know, teamed up not too long ago, so we know Suzumi, I guess, is throwing the upper sister back?
I suppose so.
I mean, it's kind of hard to read Suzumi sometimes, but ooh, look at that.
Ooh. Daring him to come on as both men were trying to go for knee strikes, but don't! Oh! It's Takeru. Oh! Kenzo trying to play Takeru's game there with the kicks.
Both men train forearm shots. Irish whip off the rope.
Jump down, leap frog.
Ooh, try to go for a jumping knee, but Kenzo able to dodge that.
Kenzo got out of the way there. That's smart. You can't afford to take those knees from Takeru. Especially considering there is no protection whatsoever on both ends with those knees.
But here's the thing, one of the most deadliest thing about Takeru is his feet. We know what those feet can do.
Exactly.
It's busted open and kind of put Zach's... It was one of the reasons why Zach Stone was put on the show. He pretty much the reason why Extreme Tony is no longer in DCA. There's many reasons why Extreme Tony's not in DCA. But anyways, it also busted open, you know, and nearly blinded, you know, Travis.
Those feet are a dangerous weapon, and the worst part about it is Takeru knows exactly how to use them.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
These Yukimura's know how to hit. And there it is again. Infinite dividends, cover no.
No.
Went for a kick right in the face, but no. Kenzo got a hold of him here. Slip suplex, floats over, cover. Does not hook the leg, puts the forearm in the face, but no.
Sorry about that, I had a phone call. Sometimes I need to leave that shit on silent.
It happens. And again, Kenza was looking to taunt Takeru, but Takeru...
Oh, Enziguri!
The deadly kicks of the man who calls himself Mr. Takedown, but there's the elbow right to the forehead. The back.
Yeesh. That was a slap. Oops, double stump right to the gut. And now look at this. Elbow.
Beams upside the head with the elbow strike.
Hooks the leg. One. Just a one. And, oh, look at it. Oh, whoa, look at this. Look at this. Look at this.
Ouch.
Right in the eyes, but Takeru. Coming back here. Another.
Oh.
Springboard kick.
Those deadly feet of Takeru Yukimura.
Looks the leg here. One, two. It's scissors now, but Kenzo fighting free.
Able to break free. Oh, forearm there. Kick. Another kick. Look at these strikes. Look at these kicks from Kenzo. And now look at these elbows right to the head.
Striking it upside the head with the elbow strikes, and Kenzo is feeling it.
He is feeling it here tonight. And oh my god! Jeez!
That's the mistake.
The brutality from this man. Jesus!
Oh! Ouch. Don't!
Hip toss there. Cover hooks the leg. One, two, no. And Kenzo, checking if that was a three, but it was not.
Can't get too frustrated. Focus. What's he doing?
No.
What is he doing?
Uh-oh.
Oh my god!
Ow!
Jesus.
Ow!
Kenzo has just been just brutalizing Takeru. Now, this is the first time we've seen Kenzo here in action. When we first saw him, it was, I don't think he was actually on that takedown, somewhere in the protection truck. Oh yeah, Kenzo debuted on takedown 140. He made it perfectly clear who he wanted to fight. He wanted to fight Takeru. Two. No.
Not yet.
Again, sorry, I wasn't actually on that show. Takeru actually confronted Kenzo. Kenzo really never got to speak.
Never got to open his mouth. Okay, went face to face with him.
Ooh! No!
Went for something there, but got none of it. And now look at this, boy break. Front locks. For like suplex there, but cow, there's the knee.
That's ow.
Two, no.
That's dangerous.
Danger of the knees. As the Keru lifts up Kenzo, suplex. Keru picking up Kenzo here. Looking for a snap suplex.
And then Takeru, Jesus Christ! Trying to go for that shooting star press, but Kenzo putting up those knees.
Oh!
Oh, double foot stomp. Back out of the way. No!
Yeesh! Takeru just tossed Kenzo. Jeez.
Didn't have to toss him like that.
Well, apparently he did. And now, Takeru.
No.
Running start, no.
Now look at this.
For a running start out of the corner, but counters the chop.
Kick to the leg there. And now Kenzo, Irish whips Takeru into the corner. Oh, try to go for a Huluva kick.
Oh. It's countered. And now over the top goes Kenzo. Oh! Pele kick.
And now Kenzo to the top rope, and Kenzo, Jesus, try to go for some kind of clothesline. Now Takeru,
I think that was more like a chop.
Oh,
for the head toss.
Off the rope, and oh, try to go for a double axe out of there. Oh, misses with the clothesline.
Oh my god. These two
going back and forth here.
Kick to the gut there by Takeru. Oh, right, it misses.
Clothesline, no.
Picks him up, and jeez!
Fisherman's driver.
Decision. Get up. What are you looking for?
Tosses him to. Misses there. Let's look at these two men. Just trading.
No.
trading blows back and forth.
Not only that, they're trading counters after counter. Oh!
Shot. Skull clap there, sledding out the hand out of the ground.
That's going to be an error.
That it is.
And Takeru.
Oh!
D-shot! Sliding in for a forearm there. Takeru Yukimura goes high risk. Here he goes!
Oh, check out for a double.
Stop, no!
Boom! Backhand!
Ooh!
Looks big! One, two, no!
That's gonna smart.
Got it in.
That is Kenzo working on the arm of Takeru. Takeru getting back up to the vertical base. Forearm there. And then Takeru.
What's he thinking here?
Hoisting Kenzo up. Oh! Drapes him across the rope. And
the guy is going for here. Sliding knee strike! Off the temple.
Jeez!
And a spray for a moonsault, but no!
Wait a minute. Kenzo. Oh! Redox!
Max. Oh, one. Two. No.
The Regal Plex.
Jeez.
And now Kenzo. Uh-oh, now. Oh, hanging Takeru out to dry.
Little rope now.
Oh, dropping the forearm. Right across the head of Takeru Yukimura. And now, try to go for a scoop slam. But Takeru gets out. This is with the kick. Arm drag there by Kiryu. And oh! Look! And these kicks!
Kick.
Deadly kick and a scooting
shooting star press there by Hironin.
No.
So is he a Ronin on the path to his own redemption?
That's a good question.
Is he looking to get his honor back?
Did the loss to Claudio wake up the old Takeru?
Or is this new Takeru still prominent?
You can't really tell. Oh, nice neck breaker.
Off the rope.
Oh,
look at this. Kenzo caught the arm.
Oh.
Takeru was trying to take him down. But Kenzo.
Oh,
no! Testing. One, two.
Oh, Zaya!
Zaya!
Well,
I'm glad you're not too scarred from from last night's main event.
Look. I'm gonna leave it alone. I'm just here. All the action.
Good man.
One, two.
No.
You have come in just in time because these. Oh my goodness! Look at this
again.
Oh,
raking
no.
The eyes.
Came in at the right time for the DCA debut of one Kenzo.
Here's the thing I've noticed about Kenzo. Kenzo is not afraid to.
Wow, shotgun.
Play a little dirty.
He's not afraid to play a little dirty.
Well, absolutely not.
Just came in.
He's the veteran of the game, even though. It's been a while since we've actually seen Kenzo, I believe, in a virtual wrestling setting.
Oh.
Can you go on a little bit more about it? Wait a minute. Dove!
Kato's a special!
No.
Take off, but it's too close to the ropes. Kenzo was a bit before my time. What I could gather, he was a big star in the DWA when that was still around. And ever since then, he's kind of been like this urban legend as far as virtual wrestling is concerned. Like, people are aware that Kenzo was this big-time deal, but then he kind of disappeared, and no one knew where he was for a while.
Oh, look at this. Jesus!
He did the deal!
Did the deal! Slip. I mean, thank God for D-Wall and his connections, right?
And,
big splash!
One, two...
Ew.
No.
No.
Nada.
I mean, we talk about his debut, and what I mean by that, I mean his first appearance here in DCA. We were talking about how he just came out, and then Takeru just interrupted him. Kenzo never got a chance to speak or anything. Now he's back on takedown 140. Oh, two men. Oh my goodness, look at this. Jeez!
Oh! Christ. Cross body there.
I think Takeru feels like Kenzo is going to have to prove himself to him. Wait a minute.
Dragon suplex!
Right on top of his head!
Jesus Christ!
And a running face wash.
Oh.
I feel like Takeru feels that Kenzo needs to prove something to him before he walks around like,
oh my God!
He's some sort of big deal here in DCA. I feel like Kenzo needs to prove himself to a man that's been here since, oh God, in day one.
It's the mindset of, yeah, you may be a legend elsewhere, but here you're just like everyone else.
I think that's sort of kind of how the mindset is for a lot of people when it comes to a lot of these names, these big names coming in from the outside, like a Kenzo, like a James Frost. You know, some people were just like, hey, you're trying to take a spot. And I do not appreciate that.
No, absolutely. They are the gatekeepers of DCA. And they are going to make sure, they are going to test you to see if you are legit or not. Not to say Kenzo isn't, but Takeru's going to be the first one to make sure that he is.
Oh!
Well, I was going to say, you know, you have to wait and see, but for right now, Kenzo looking like he hasn't lost a step.
No, absolutely. Again, veteran of the game. He's been here a long-ass time. There's not a lot Takeru will be able to catch him with that he has not seen before.
Oh! Oh, God. Good shots.
Well, there's those deadly kicks of Takeru. Jesus Christ!
Oh,
my God, what a German!
One, two.
No.
Not just yet. Not pretty much deadlifting him off of his feet. Oh, God. Takeru now with what he knows best, and it's those damn strikes.
Incredible strikes.
No! God! He just caught a mouthful of Takeru's foot right in his face.
You gonna guard there?
What he caught was a straight shoot kick in the face.
Oh, well, hello.
Oh, well, hey. sorry I'm late. My mind's been a bit all over the place today.
You mean after, like, what happened last night?
After what happened last night, but also with what's to come today.
What is this?
Oh my God!
Jesus Christ! Avalanche German suplex!
Oh, and he's not done.
He's gonna follow up here. Double stomp, no. Takeru moves. Nope. Snapmare. Single leg dropkick.
Too many. So, Kenzo Takeru, have I missed anything, or is this the opener tonight?
This is the
opener.
One, two,
no.
Yes, and I apologize to the fans for not knowing the sheet, but I've only just arrived in the building. Let's compliment some things today.
Hey, you and me both.
Right, well, thing it with this one is, I'm pretty certain, I don't know, so high as mentioned, Jason's mentioned, both these guys show similar styles.
I think Jason mentioned that.
Yeah.
Both guys also share a similar controversy in a sense of seeing Takeru, you know, even though it looks a bit like his old self here tonight.
Kinda.
You know, wait a minute, hold a second. Kenzo's looking to die!
Jesus!
Suicide dive into the rail!
Shoved him right into the barricade there.
Drove him into the barricade.
That was destructive.
Yeah, as I was saying, both guys have, in a sense, a similar background. One, Kenzo, if you remember, during the heyday, was a part of the legitimate wrestling movement with Corey Jones.
Oh, yeah.
And that caused a hell of a lot of controversy.
For those who are... Oh, God! Those kind of like me who weren't around that time, would you mind explaining what exactly that was?
Legitimate wrestling movement was a movement led by Corey Jones, where they wanted to legitimize wrestling. It was the bane of existence of the VWA, WWI, SWF, and URWL fan bases. They wanted to destroy, in a sense, all hardcore wrestling.
They wanted to turn professional wrestling into their own image, no matter who it got in the way of or who it destroyed in the process.
Yes.
One of those being a man that Corey Jones knows very well in the form of Scorpio.
Yeah, his own brother.
Yeah, he sold out his own brother for it. Meanwhile, the thing is, though, with Takeru, let's be honest. Takeru, we all know about the blood trail, which happened earlier this year.
We don't even know still if Takeru's with or not with them anymore.
Fucking all we know,
for all we know, he could be. I mean, we hope not, but for all we know, he could be. Overhead bite
him! Oh no, this it's a big night for those absolute bunch of bleaching bastards tonight. You know, with the Wildcats title and so much more going on tonight.
Yeah, to be fair, even though I hate that bitch with a passion, she may or might not even be able to be in that match. Even though she said they put me in that match. If she's not medically cleared, she's not medically cleared.
She'll do it anyway!
That is at her own detriment.
And if it ends up with her in a wheelchair, good fucking riddance, I don't give a shit.
Look, alright, I don't like Destiny as much as the next person, but honestly, I don't want to see her career ended. Seems like a bit of a...
What she said?! You don't want to see her career ended?
I
don't want her career to be ended. What I do want is someone to beat the ever-loving shit out of her till she realizes, hey, you know, all the shit you've been saying has been full of fucking shit.
Drunk told, and I think Takeru's bleeding.
Oh!
And that kick landed right on the chin. Yeah, he's bleeding. Right, you know what? I can compromise to that, okay? But I do want to see what Jason said, okay? I want to see the shit get beat out of her.
If anything, she needs to get humbled.
But when it comes to the fucking little rat, screw Korea being ended because he never had one, I'm going to shoot and say this. You all know who I'm on about. I want his life to be ended.
See, the thing with Destiny is, she doesn't deserve to be wheelchair bound. She just deserves to have a reality check. Moving on.
That's a good way to put it.
And for the slam ball, I hope he gets a bullet between his eyes.
That's fair. As right
you
now,
all know who I'm on about.
Yeah, we know.
Enzo. I'm not saying anything about this.
What is this?
Rampbuster? That
was a knee.
Forearm. More forearms. Uh-oh, that's got Kenzo Rocker, so I...
Oh, God, look at the blood ball going from... That is suddenly started busting out, which is not a good sign.
Wait a minute!
There's the Bailey!
There it is! And just like that, just like always, Kenzo has been busted open.
There you go.
Suddenly, the barefooted Bailey.
That Pele kick always gets the job done. It always gets the bust that gets your opponent.
Sling blade good from Kenzo.
This is the most dangerous Pele in all of virtual wrestling.
It's mostly because the man wrestles without shoes.
Yeah.
Which is both a advantage and a disadvantage because it's the bare feet, you know, bare bone and everything, but at the same time, your feet is easily targeted.
Ah!
there it is again.
Oh no!
Oh, look what two Pele kicks did to him.
He is just a gushing mess.
Oh. Irish whip into the corner. What is this?
Oh no.
Oh no.
Oh Jesus.
Well, I'm going to say it. Kenzo, I think the most overused death spot in virtual wrestling, a superplex to the floor.
Ow.
That's how you bring break your guys back.
Ouch. That's going to hurt.
As now, Kenzo bringing Takeru back in. Takeru's back might be broken. Now she picks.
Oh no.
We kind of begin our night the same way we kind of ended last night with a lot of blood being shed. I don't want to talk about it, but we're here.
Go! Oh, wait. Oh, Monahan.
Sharp palm strike.
Both men are just gushing right now.
They're both bloody messes. They're both in a lot of trouble. Big kicks here from Takeru.
Big kicks.
And now, unleashing up. Kenzo.
Forearm.
Looking for Shotgun Knee!
Right into the turnbuckle on the back of Kenzo's head bunched off each one.
Wait, oh my god, Kenzo got up! Patoso Brainbuster!
Takeru keeps up!
The adrenaline from Takeru!
Fighting spirit being shot by Kenzo!
Rolls up with the least up kick!
Joe, he's super special!
Ow.
Fighting spirit being shown by both men. German from Kenzo, but Takeru's hands were underneath that bottom rope.
Yeah, unfortunately, bad ring positioning.
Dizzy with the hands. Oh no.
Dragon! Two.
No. Able to roll out. Barely able to roll out.
Big punch there.
Good. God, you could hear that from back here.
That's the definition of a another knife edge shot there from Kenzo.
I'm gonna say it. Those are Kenta Kobashi style chops. With how wide and impactful they are, Sahaya.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Oh, no.
Mobile right hands into the court, and Kenzo now. Maybe looking for the most overused.
Nice! He's in the deal!
The super deal!
Avalanche Falcon Arrow at the corner.
He's not finished. And no!
Knee to the head! Turn it from Takeru!
Full Nelson spin outside slam!
Straight in with a Toriel press! Slingshot moves on off the second rope! Exactly what you said, Rick. Lion salt to the chest.
And now again with the kicks, the strikes.
Oh, kick right to the wall rope. Oh, the open.
Just unloading with the kick, saying, hey, you may have impactful strikes to carry, but I'm just as good.
Both men are landing signature shots here. Can I be clear?
These two are going to absolute war here tonight. I mean, Redemption is regarded as, hold up here, small pack.
He's got his bolt on right now. He hasn't.
But I will say, What else can they expect from this night? Redemption is always regarded as the bloodiest and most violent night in the bloodiest history. Suplex to the outside by Kenzo.
He deadlifted, and I don't know if y'all saw it, that wasn't a natural motion. Kenzo deadlifted him into that suplex.
And considering that Takeru already took a superplex to the outside, that's not going to do him any more favors.
Kick!
Shiny was it!
Shiny boot right to the face! No! That wasn't the knee, that was the boot! Right off the face!
Wants him to get up.
Kenzo, I know in the past he's gone for that GTS. It's what he's not many people out with in the past. Oh!
Think of something. Or hit it quick. Wait a second, again with the brain bust.
No, not that time. It's the curve.
Wait a minute.
GTS!
Not today!
GTS!
GTS!
Two sleep! Tag's great!
1, 2,
over!
3 GTSs in a row!
Jesus Christ!
My God!
Surprised he took one and still stood straight up after it. You take it, 3, you're going straight to bed. You're going to the moon.
You're going down. That's usually the case. But here's that.
Good God.
Running, shining wizard.
That's what changed it.
Yeah, that
running kick.
It's what opened up the gates.
That rocket kick just flocked Takeru.
I don't think Takeru was completely into it after that. I mean, he tried to be, but this drop toe hold comes after it. No, there's the drop toe hold into the ropes. Try to go for the clothesline, didn't get it. Look to hit this patella brainbuster again. Couldn't get it there. Runs off the ropes, gets caught immediately on the shoulders.
Yes.
Tried to go for Dragon's Wrath, couldn't get it.
GTS again, and as before he fell.
GTS. One more for good measure. Made sure that he was completely out of it. 1, 2, good night. It's over. Kenzo.
One more for the road.
Huge victory for Kenzo.
Absolutely.
In his GTA debut, Kenzo walks away with the win.
Not just any win, a win over a former DCA World Champion, a two-time DCA World Champion.
That's how you send a statement. I heard Jason, you said, about these new guys coming in.
Mm-hmm.
And like how the gatekeepers don't want to give up their spot. That was Kenzo taking a spot right there.
Abso-freaking-lutely.
Kenzo breaking down
what
the door.
What a battle.
Letting everyone know. I'm here.
He's here, and he's here for the gold.
And he's a guy you've got to keep both eyes on. Believe that. That right there, guys, is one of the most dangerous men in this company. I don't think much needs more to be said.
Revy making it perfectly clear that after she is done with Roberta, she is coming back for that Wildcats Championship, no matter who holds that belt in the end of by the end of this
but
night.
She ain't going for the Wildcats title first. She's got someone who ran from her 2 years ago to get to first.
Mm-hmm. We are going to see a bloodbath later tonight when it comes to Revy and Roberta.
All I'm going to say is I hope Revy puts that weapon in the ground. Anyway,
we're moving on.
Oh boy!
You hear that music? It could only be one woman.
This right here is as personal a match as any on this show.
That is true.
And I can tell you firsthand how personal this is. The rivalry between this woman right here, the Venus of Submission Toshimi Minami, and her opponent tonight, Sakura Hagiwara. By the way, Scarlet Empire Exchange case on the line in this. Has not only dated back over the Queens of Wrestling tag titles, not only here in DCA, but also, not only in ACW, but also in SCA, where these two have tried to kill each other in a sense. Or at least kill each other's careers. But the Venus of Submission in the ring. We await Sekai de Ichiban. Toshimi Minami in the ring! And you hear the music. And there she is.
Oh boy.
One half of the Queens of Wrestling Tag Team Champions. One half of Sweet Diva. But here tonight, the reigning and defending Scarlet Empire Exchange briefcase holder, the strongest in the world, Sekai de Ichiban, Sakura Hagiwara.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but didn't the Sweet Divas defeat Yuri Shinada and Toshimi Minami to win
back
the
fight? Back up the stage for you, correct.
Why it's what makes this match all the more interesting when you think about it.
It's not only that, this blood feud these two have had going on over in SCA. Sakura with Elena Miyasawa has had a blood feud going with Toshimi Minami. Two things. Toshimi tried to end Sakura's career. That didn't work. Toshimi would then put Sakura on the shelf with rib punches. I don't know what shape, you know, Sakura's rib cage is in. Can I be clear?
Yeah.
So, there is... Both these women have, in a sense, looked to hurt each other. We've seen Toshimi at Sakura before with a shoulder as well. Y'all remember the helmet tournament and how much that troubled her?
true.
For Toshimi Minami, it is a chance to get a golden opportunity. For Sakura Hagiwara, it is not only a chance at redemption, but it is a chance at the most fitting revenge as we are underway with this grudge match for the Scarlet Empire Exchange case.
I mean, this kind of started off as, you know, it was just two women, you know, looking to fight to see who's the best, but in the midst of that, it's just turned into something more vicious and brutal along the way.
Something more personal.
Yes.
I think every, barring the opener, I think every match on this card has something personal in a sense on the line here tonight.
This is more than the briefcase. This is more than just proving a point. This is about a whole lot more.
Both women starting off hot right now. Sakura grabbing Toshimi by the head, or by the hair, actually.
Yeah, you can throw competitive respect out the window on this one. Can I be clear?
Yeah.
There's no love lost here.
And now Sakura, leapfrog, ducks down, tries to hit her with the anti, moving out of the way, does Toshimi. Catching her in the clubbing blow to the back of the head.
You can't make mistakes like that against Toshimi Minami.
Oh, and neither can Minami against Sakura.
Both these women are excellent technical wrestlers. You make a mistake, you will pay for it. Duplex lands on her feet.
Has her hooked up.
Regalplex with the bridge hooked.
And immediately, Sakura kicking out at one. Not even going to give Minami, you know, the satisfaction of a two count here. I don't think Minami really cares. She'll do it again if she has to. This time she just releases it. Just blatant disrespect from Toshimi. Just trying to get inside. He's trying to get inside the head of Sakura here.
As I said, there ain't a lot of respect here. Can I be clear? Hell, there's no respect here. Let me be honest. Let me be clear. They are respectful as competitors, okay? But between them both in the ring, with everything that's happened between these two, there ain't any respect here.
I mean, you gotta respect, you know, these two's, like, wrestling ability. I think that's where the respect lies. They have respect in each other's abilities and knowing what they might pull out in the ring. That's as far as it will go, though. As far as, like, personal issues are concerned, it's as serious as it gets.
By the way, I'm gonna mention this right now. The Sakura we had at Prestige ain't the Sakura we've got here tonight.
Absolutely not. Oh, God. No. Oh, God. This is not Sweet Diva Sakura. No. Hagi, what we're seeing. This is Big Match Sakura at her finest right now.
So she did put her right. No, this is Sakura with something to prove. We have seen Sakura Hagiwara when she's had something to prove. Look at Oseiko. Look at Reiko Hinamoto. Look at Juri Sanada. Let me list those three names. Whenever Sakura Hagiwara has had something to prove, she stepped up, and guess what? She's beaten him, in a sense, when she's had to beat him.
Cover. One, two.
No.
Well, Sakura, that's always the interesting case. You know, sometimes she steps up to the plate and she gets the job done. Sometimes that's not always the case, though. That's what makes Sakura such, you know, always why she strives to be the best, is that she doesn't always get the better. I think back to last year, last redemption, where she had that big match with Oseiko, and
won the goddess title. Like, if you remember, she won the goddess title off her.
Yeah, she beat Oseiko right in the middle of the ring. It was one of the most, it was one of Sakura's defining moments here in DCA.
It is the truth. Call out truth coming in right now. Sakura Hagiwara, and by the way, this could be a difference to this match. Yeah, she had a mixed prestige. She won the tag titles, but remember in that singles bout, she's looking for a big singles win this year.
Yeah.
How crazy is that? She's not had one this year. think back to CCL and her bombshells title reign. Ow, that was a stomp on the head, and no, that ended at Forsaken.
Yeah, she lost that to one Carmen Cortez.
Who, by the way, is still fucking AWOL. Shut up! Annie then defeated her at Prestige 3. And that was biting, and I'm not surprised. Toshimi Minami has had a number in SCA. Only Sakura only has one win over Toshimi over there. So Sakura has been struggling this year, you know, for notches in the win column.
Yeah,
absolutely. She needs to get that one thing that'll get her on that hot streak. What is this?
Sakura trying to get out of it, but she got trapped.
She got trapped
in a bad way.
Sarah Miedold on the floor.
Oh my god.
Here's the cold hard truth. The only advantage Sakura Hagiwara has going for her here tonight is that she is used to this redemption stage. She is, if I am correct on my record, I believe I am, and Sahaya could correct me, she is 3-1 up this redemption stage.
I believe you would be right.
The one loss being to Reiko.
Yes.
And then there was a win of, if I remember correct. Oh, hold on, what the hell?
What is
Sakura doing? Sorry, I need to correct myself. It's 2-1, okay?
She got the win over KYN, and then...
When her career was on the line in that FIFA title match.
Right.
And then let's remember, it was the big DDT! And then let's remember, it was the Osako win as well.
Yes.
You know, this year, you know, Sakura just needs that big win, and this might be it.
It might be. However...
Oh, my God!
It will not be if she makes mistakes like that. Oh, my God. And now look at Toshimi with the Tiger Suplex, landing her right on her head. Toshimi has proven that she has Sakura's number. She has Sakura scouted in every single shape and form. Oh my god! As you can see right there, she tried to go for a butterfly suplex. Sakura got out of it, but immediately captured her with that snap German.
Oh, but and by the way, something else we need to just say. And this is truth. Sakura Hagiwara's schedule. Think about this.
Yeah, it's been very scarce as of late.
Compared to previously when it was, you know.
Yeah.
She would always be in action in a sense.
And again, you can put that mostly on Toshimi Minami. Oh, wait a minute. Neckbreaker! From the middle rope! Here's the collar hook in the legs!
No.
Toshimi kicks out.
Takeru looking to do the damage, looking to put her away. Lobby off the jaw!
Sharp clothesline.
Sakura on the top rope. Has Toshimi in her sights. Crossbody gets caught out of midair. Backbreaker from Toshimi Minami.
Out to the middle rope.
And a miss from Minami.
That was not good.
And as I stated before, you cannot make mistakes in this sort of boat.
No, absolutely not.
Close hands missed. Sakura short forearms!
Has her rocked!
Over the top she goes.
And that's not good.
From Sakura!
JTG Memorial Sling Blade from Sakura Hagiwara!
Oh god, right on the floor as well. Just planted her on the floor.
Now what's Sakura thinking?
Oh, I know what she's thinking. Rob Hunt, Neckbreaker!
Oh, God, a straight whiplash neckbreaker on the thinly padded floor.
And that was something, and that's something you don't usually see from Sakura Hagiwara. A more vicious side.
Yeah, absolutely not. For this, but this is no ordinary Sakura. This is Sakura Domination! As she gets her head taken off with that lariat from Toshimi. And now look at this.
This is Sakura Hagiwara with something to prove and a grudge to settle.
But that's Toshimi true. Minami also not looking to be denied here tonight. She wants to prove that she is undoubtedly better than Sakura Hagiwara.
There is so much underlying hatred here between, you know, both these women.
It is really a situation that's gotten out of hand very quickly, you know, before our very eyes.
Whoa. Drop kick, all down the feet. Rolling elbow!
Rolling elbow straight to the face, and now Toshimi on the top rope. Sakura starting to stir, though.
Slowly up to her feet.
Toshimi now rolling.
Body is caught, and that is problem for Toshimi Minami.
And now she is the one that is caught out of midair. But look at this.
Sakura right there was trying to set him up for a soft serve. Toshimi knew what was coming. Enzi!
Bouncing off the ropes. Toshimi now. Wait a second.
Oh,
Sakura.
She caught him.
Oh, my God.
She took the bait. Sakura took the bait and Toshimi capitalized.
Oh, look at the old school reverse elbow drop right to the ribs again.
One, two. No. It's a Kenru.
And I mentioned those ribs because guess what? Toshimi was the one that injured Sakura's ribs.
Yep, like brought up earlier.
So, plain and simple, if there's anyone who's going to know where Sakura's weak in this battle, it's going to be Toshimi.
Look, Toshimi knew exactly what she was doing when she did that as well. She knew that she'd be weakening her up before this contest. She has a target. She has a target now. And she's going to...
She's going to exploit that weakened part of Sakura.
Exactly, Chase.
Swats
on off the rope!
There's a one. There's the two.
No. Shoulder up. Toshimi got the shoulder up. Monahan right in position.
Sakura now. What does she have planned here?
That's Minami to get up. Close. Nope. No.
Oh, tiger faint kick.
Has her now. Snap suplex. Oh, now look at this. Another one. Ball. Three amigos, perhaps. Oh, wait,
two amigos and a perfect friend, but unfortunately for Toshimi, Sakura was in the ropes.
That is that's very rare that you see Toshimi with bad ring positioning. Oh, no!
Oh, Monahan. Monahan done straight up.
A backdrop,
no! This referee in the game. What? Sakura able to land on a few-dot Minami position. Storm Cradle Driver!
One! Two!
No!
Not able to hold her!
We've seen Sakura pull out that Stone Cradle Driver before. One of Sakura's most signature maneuvers. It was not able to get the job done, though.
Goes Sakura to the outside. Toshimi.
Off the rope. Toshimi's actually gonna die! Oh,
okay. So peak on hero.
New barrel.
Exactly. No touch as well.
I'm trying to get up.
Oh, stop. With a big knee. Sends her into the barricade. Oh, God! Just spine first into the barricade, courtesy of Sakura Hagiwara.
Into the ring they go.
Sakura now telling Toshimi to get back to her feet. She's on the apron, looking for something here.
Neckbreaker!
This time she got it.
Cover. One, two.
No. Shoulder up.
Sakura actually having some words from Monahan there, actually thinking that was a three count, but it was not to be. Monahan counted two.
Oh, nice knee.
Oh no! You could just see Sakura crumbling, and now Toshimi taking advantage again with that arm!
And I'll tell you why she's going for that arm. Trying to remind Sakura of the past.
Exactly.
Reminding her of how she put her out when she almost separated her shoulder in half.
Uh-huh.
It's not only called beating them physically, it's called beating them mentally.
Oh my god.
Well, she's not going to have anything mentally there if Sakura keeps hitting her with headbutts.
Sakura, squash! What with knees?
Couldn't get it.
What is this?
What the hell? Right out again, into the armbar. Oh no, Sakura's trying to transition, and that's leading into the trap.
No.
It's the third time in this match.
Again.
That Toshimi is gonna break the arm. Try to at least.
I honestly don't know if Sakura might have a separated shoulder at this point. It's very possible.
Would you play into Toshimi's game? You all know what Toshimi will look to end it with. Either that cross armbar or the Kimura lock.
Oof!
Which we've seen her, you know.
She's stomping on the top of her head!
Oh my God.
And then a knee! Toshimi may also look for the KO!
She might be trying to give her a straight concussion for all we know. Sakura, though, has her up against the ropes.
Sakura at the ropes, tornado style DDT!
Nicely done. But she's not done just yet.
I will say this, if the pace quickens, it suits Miss Sakura Hagiwara, but there's the knees again.
But you don't want to go too fast. That could lead you to make a mistake, as we just saw there with that frog splash. Whoa. Oh. And now, goodness gracious. One, two. No. Just a straight face buster from Toshimi Minami. Nothing pretty there. Oh, wait. Now Sakura.
Another attempt at the Storm Cradle, maybe?
Oh, wait. No.
Power switch. Powerbomb.
One, two. No.
No.
You could see Sakura immediately going down to a knee. You could see the effects of this match taking a toll on her.
Both women going back and forth here.
It would be in Sakura's best interest to get this one as quickly done as possible. But we know with Toshimi, that's a lot easier said than done.
Oh, yeah.
Reverse power slam, and now Sakura is setting her up for something. Where? Nope.
Shut up the jaw! Straight forearm! Punny able driven into your jaw.
And look at Sakura's eyes right now. She's not even there. The lights are on, but no one's home.
And this could be a chance for Toshimi Minami to finish this all off.
What the hell? She's got her underhook. Butterfly superplex from Toshimi Minami into the pin. One, two, no! Still not enough.
Oh,
what?
Kick missed.
How's
her
by the arm? Die!
Oh, Sakura wrenching Toshimi down by the arm.
Oh.
And a bit of payback though for Sakura.
Yeah, giving her a little taste of her own medicine.
Knee shot.
Straight to the ribs too. Oh God!
Heavy strikes on both ladies.
Going back and forth right now. Forearms for Sakura. Oh no!
Toshimi went down, but she was able to roll out the way. But a big right hand dizzies her.
That's her.
Uplex.
No,
Sakura able to land on her feet. Almost both ladies almost getting caught in the ropes, so that almost got real dangerous. More forearms!
Oh my god! Ooh.
Double forearm Dizzy and Toshimi. Sakura top rope! Moonsault! What a man! It's a double moonsault!
Missing the first time with the missing the first time landing on her feet, then course corrected herself with a standing moonsault. That was excellent planning there from Sakura Hagiwara.
Oh, nice kick.
Oh, returning favor.
Oh, jeez.
Uppercut. Oh, that was a slap!
Straight back to the face. A clear sign for disrespect. Wait a second, what is Toshimi?
Toshimi's gonna drill the knees for Sakura's wrist!
Oh no! Oh, and now you can see. Referee having to back off Toshimi.
Having to take a look.
Yeah, checking up on Sakura here.
Oh. Punch right to the side of the head.
One hand says she can still go, but I don't know. It could be just a matter of time before Toshimi puts this one away.
Right hand to Sakura, but Toshimi counters.
Oh, big shot. And a chop
with both women just exchanging strikes.
Look at this.
Neither woman. Go ahead, Sarah.
They're just trying to hammer away at each other, hitting each other with anything they can. Oh my god. It is a straight up war of attrition we are seeing right here in the middle of this ring.
It's the back and forth. Who's going to get the upper hand?
Oh, big kick.
But look at that. Sokka continues to stay on her. And out. Right!
Sakura, big bulldog!
Toshimi getting out of the ring.
Forearm.
I don't think Sakura had enough energy within her to do a dive like she would normally do.
I mean, you have to think how much the body hurts in the shoulder, the ribs.
Yeah, absolutely.
Although these two women have, let's be honest, this has been a strong style matchup again. Just like her opener. Strikes Athena, her apparent big DDT from Sakura.
And now, no!
Swanton is a no.
Oh, good!
German suplex.
Two! And Sakura again kicks out! And now gets caught!
Oh, no.
You never want to count out the heart of Sakura Hagiwara.
Ladies going back and forth. There's a chop again for Sakura. That one hurt Toshimi. Toshimi right hand. Sakura clubbing blow.
But while I say that, the heart might want what her body cannot give her. At some point, you know, with all of these shots from Toshimi, with all these suplexes and throws and just targeting limbs, Sakura might not have that much left in the tank.
The fighting spirit will never ever give her out of either of these studies, but you are right, Sahaya. The body may give, but Sakura!
No!
The home driver!
One, two! No!
No! We're not going on yet, though.
Not just yet.
And now look at this. Gut-wrench suplex and still has her. Deadlifting her from the ground.
Now that is signature Sakura Hagiwara.
One, two, but it's still not enough. Sakura trying to go after Toshimi. Toshimi pushes her off though. Oh, she saw it coming that time!
Spinebuster!
Right on the pine! 1, 2, 3 No!
Not yet.
Both these women just laying it all inside. Look at another string wall! Another step German! 1, 2 No! No! What else
do these, chop.
What else do these women have left? You gotta ask yourselves.
Maybe not much. Drop kick! And a second go to hospital!
In the fucking tent! Sakura from the tippity top rope! Toshimi!
Going for...
Oh! Missile drop kick!
That was on the jaw!
Sakura still not finished the... Oh. Front flush! 1, 2, 2
No!
No!
The 8-star frog splash, not enough to put away Toshimi.
He thought that was it.
It wasn't.
Clothesline blocked. Tap suplex.
Here we go again.
And this can she hit it? Away from the ropes. Yes, she does. Middle of the ring. She's got her perfectly.
Yes, right now.
No.
No. Fishy with suplex only two.
Even through all of this, even going for as long as they have, I don't think either woman has been able to pull out any of their big maneuvers just yet.
Not just yet. Oh. They will soon enough.
1, 2 No!
No! Kick missed!
And now Sakura missing with the drop kick. Whoa!
I thought that was blocked. And the corner goes to Toshimi.
The hell is she planning here? Nope, nothing. Toshimi now in her sights. Wait a second, no, Sakura!
Oh, Sakura just cut her off with a kick! That kick was on the bottom!
Oh, is it time? Oh, what is
that?
For the most overused move in Virtual Wrestling, the Super
Flex! Wait a second, she rolls through into the deal!
Get the
fucking arrow!
But she's not finished!
What else could she be going with? What is this?
They're looking to cover up on it!
No!
Oh, lands on the feet. Toshimi hits again. Regal!
Again.
Blast! Release style this time, dropping Sakura right on her head.
Oh my god. What a forearm. Oh, the forearm.
Throwing shots.
Going off the ropes. Knee!
Let's knee on the button!
1, 2
Two.
No.
No! Didn't get it.
Toshimi now on the middle row. Sakura still getting back to her feet, but for how much longer?
Forearm is a miss! That's a kick.
Oh, and you could see Toshimi is fired up now after that.
She landed that Lariato perfectly.
Got out of it.
Big chop.
Another
chop.
No, God, big chop.
Uh-oh. Here comes Sakura!
Huge shot.
A huge suicide dive from Sakura Hagiwara. As it looks like now she is finding her second win. Even after all the punishment she has withstood in this contest.
It's been one hell of a, you know, a fight.
Yeah.
It has.
I think it's... fair to mention now, I believe at this point that these women have been going for a good 30 minutes now.
That is true, 30 minutes and they're still going.
As now Toshimi puts her near the bear. What's she thinking up here? Oh my god! Oh my god! She just speared her through the barricade!
Right through the barricade.
And as if Sakura's body wasn't broken already. I mean, that might have just sealed the deal there.
That may have broken Sakura in half.
Toshimi now. Gonna take advantage of me. No! She missed! No! Turns her around!
Big shot. Sakura will fight back with back elbows.
Just straight back and forth between the two. Four missed. Shot.
Headbutt. Headbutt. And a big right hand.
And now, Sakura might be looking to go on a drive-by!
And there was nothing sweet about that! That was 2 feet right in the side of the head!
Oh, no!
Big kick!
From out of nowhere!
Landed flush as well! Jawbreaker, though.
Rolling elbow yet again. That Tenru elbow drop misses. Big punch.
Sakura drop kick to the side of the head.
Whoa!
Roots up missed.
And forearm.
Right on the jaw. Body shot.
Dead. Kick. And there's a straight punch.
Rapid fire punches.
Oh my god!
No, big moonsault.
I don't think she's done. Reborn! Shooting star pressed! Tries to trip her.
Oh!
Toshimi pushes her back. Back elbow. There's a chop. Another chop. Here comes Sucker!
Ah! She got caught off!
Good lord! Right in the back! Right in their back into the barricade!
And now Toshimi just looking to do more damage on the ribs and the back. Look at that. Oh, body shots!
Right to the ribs. And what in the hell is Toshimi
Penis
thinking
of
here?
Submission!
Dang! Good lord! Spinning leg drop while Sakura was draped across the barricade. You would think this would have to be the end. It's now Toshimi. No!
On to the Sakura God!
Reverse power slam yet again.
Inverted power slam.
Chest and face hit the canvas.
Uh-oh.
Swings her around with the soft serve. She drilled her into the canvas.
Toshimi though, still trying to get back to her feet. And Sakura says no way.
That was a soft serve of, some added, violence behind it.
Yeah. Oh, wait a minute.
A rolling. Look, big. Could you steal it? This would be a bit of a steal, though. Vitriol cradle pin, almost got it. Oh, just dragged it in by the ear.
Pretty much sending her the back of her head into the canvas.
Forearm.
Chop. Chop.
Another chop.
Chop.
Oh, fucking chop back. Forearm. Forearm.
They're just not stopping.
Oh! Oh! Big kick!
One! Two!
No! Shoulder up at the last second!
Good God!
These two have just waged the war. Let's be honest here.
I mean, you're absolutely right. Oh no, here we go!
Oh, whoa! Oh, and the other feet!
Toshimi off the ropes! Wake is
Sakura the ropes! First, Sakura got the sunset with Pacquiao! One! Two! She is done!
No, she hasn't.
Oh my God!
Ah, brought it down by the neck!
Neck breaker there from Sakura. Has all
oh, I'm dizzy enough. That was a stiff arm. Toshimi's still able to fight back.
Up to the arm! To the arm! To the arm!
Yeah! Right to the arm, extending it not only over the top rope but with a foot!
Oh my
body shot! Dog going right for the face!
Toshimi's getting desperate! Toshimi is getting
Oh my God!
Ow!
Toshimi Minami is starting to get desperate here! Oh, Jesus!
She's getting desperate. She knows this match is most likely almost over. All it takes is one wrong move. That's all
one
it takes.
All
it takes is one fatal mistake from either lady, and this one is done.
Especially with two athletes like these two, Minami and
God, Sakura. That might be it! He missed the kick!
Three points!
You said one fatal mistake, Chase!
That could be it!
Mistake!
That could be it!
God.
No!
Knees up!
No!
Oh my God!
Picks her up! No!
Holy hell, what a wrestling match!
I mean, we kind of finished it!
Oh. She missed it again!
Pushed off! Whoa!
Uh-oh.
Irish whip!
Oh,
whip
God,
it comes through again!
God!
Stumble, Colbio, right out of here!
You gotta do it again? He's gotta do it again!
It is Ice Cream City, bitch! There's the second Germans!
Is it time? Ice Cream! You scream!
You scream!
We all scream! For Ice Cream!
There we go!
Ice Cream Somersault on the money! And that usually is the prelude to sweet motherfucking dreams!
Got it!
Got all of it! Oh, she's not done.
She's
Sakura,
looking for a statement.
Sakura, that's
she's looking
too
for
far.
A statement.
Sakura, oh, that's too far.
It's halfway across the ring. Sweet dreams halfway across the ring. Statement made. Statement won. Sakura Hagiwara retains the Scarlet Empire Exchange briefcase.
In the absolute clutch, Sakura Hagiwara does it again.
Not only in the clutch, Sahaya and Chase, but with a statement.
Most definitely.
This was the match Sakura knew in her heart that she could not afford to lose at any cost. And even though Toshimi Minami brought her A game, she damn near tortured Sakura throughout this entire contest. Sakura never gave up. She never gave in to the Venus of Submission. And at the final hour, she was able to get the job done.
What a match. Jeez.
Absolutely. I mean, we want to just look at this right here. Try to get her with that gut buster. Yet again, Sakura countered into the painkiller. Toshimi countered with the Minami roll. Couldn't get that. Went off the rope. Sakura unfortunately missing that enziguri. Toshimi thinking she had her this time. But Sakura out of nowhere. German. And another German.
And then we'll trio it up, as we all know Sakura does perfectly, the German suplex trio.
And then just like that, ice cream somersault on the money.
And then here was the statement. Watch this. This is what we call making a statement. Can we be clear?
Well, there's one. That was the first statement.
But she could have picked her on, probably won the match.
No. Not like. We gotta add the exclamation point to this. We gotta add the permanent end with a second Sweet Dreams. And it was Sweet Dreams for Toshimi Minami here at Redemption. What an absolute war by those two. And congratulations for Sakura Hagiwara. She earned that victory.
That she did. This sweet redemption for Sakura Hagiwara. How fitting at the event name Redemption.
It has become her own moniker in a sense. Whenever Redemption rolls around, Sakura seemingly gets hers almost every time.
You're damn right. That right there is a big fight feel.
Kenshin
versus Malik Brown. Malik and Kenshin is not only a fight for the Celestial title, that is a fight between two guys who have known each other for years.
Full-on decade plus between them.
Never met each other. And here's the thing. We all know how close Malik was to the TCW roster.
Yeah.
You remember Dead Man Wonderland?
Yeah, that's true.
All those years back? Sahaya?
Yeah, I remember.
Anyway, we got to move on, and judging by I hear that music, I hear Suicide Girl music, so this is a grudge match right here.
Oh, you know what it's time for.
This
matchup has been a long time making it. I'm back, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry about that. I had a phone call to take.
No, it's okay, Rick. Welcome back.
This woman right here.
What
is that?
God.
Can someone explain to me what that is?
I will explain to you what that is. Ladies and gentlemen, that ain't Amy Lynn. That's a shadow. The darkest side of the leader of the Suicide Girls coming out and... It's kind of fitting, in a sense, considering that Amy Lynn, in a sense, split this fight with Akira, because here's the thing. Some of the unfortunate that has happened within Emilian's career, guess who she kind of blames for it?
Akira.
Yeah.
Last year at the anniversary show. It was last year's anniversary show, Emilian fought Akira. Emilian back then was trying to reunite the Suicide Girls. Akira will beat her quite decisively. The two words which have been themed around this night so far, night two, have been revenge and redemption. This is another match with that involved. Like, there ain't much to say. There is a question though. What condition is Akira Yukimura in? She wrestled only 24 hours ago, guys.
Mm-hmm.
Hell, less than 24 hours ago, if we're being honest. We await the Empress.
For weeks on end, Emilian has blindsided Akira, to my knowledge.
You're right.
It all comes to a head.
There we go! For the second time of this Redemption weekend, we await the Empress!
Well, unfortunately, one Melissa Hart's not here to do it, so allow me if I... Whoa, wait a minute! Well,
and
right
that's
now...
That's a whole different looking Empress!
Ladies and gentlemen, New Look Society, it is now time for the Empress to rise.
Akira Yukimura coming off an absolute war last night, if you remember.
With Alan B. Martin.
Yeah, and by the way, something else we mentioned. Her opponent still has a bout later on tonight. Ambi's gonna go in that Wildcats tag title thing, but we don't know who her partner's gonna be. But Akira Yukimura here tonight. And by the way, did you see the drum? Oh, we can get another shot of it. And do you see the color scheme even? Bit of gold in there.
Yeah.
One thing we have seen, Akira. Go ahead, Chase.
I didn't notice the new color scheme.
Yeah, the one thing that Akira Yukimura has been forming as of late all over social media, I've seen it also at SCA, has been the form of a new dynasty. I don't know if any of them are here. Oh my god.
Yeesh.
Look how different Emilian looks. And we usually say that about Akira, can I be clear?
Mm-hmm.
That's... I'm just gonna say it. Emilian tonight is someone who is fighting, in a sense, not only for redemption, but it seems that her revenge has consumed her. If you look how she looks.
Like it's what it like that the markings on her face are like, it's like her own revenge is just seeping out of her, taking over her,
because she sees who's across the ring from her again in Akira Yukimura. Like, I've seen Emilian when she's been angry before. I think back to the Wildcats title, you know, hunt she was in with Revy and Ruby Malone and my Mimi went back when that was a mess, but look at her tonight. Yeesh. That is the most demented I have ever seen, Emilin. By and far. And all she gets is a... Look at the stir Akira's giving her. Akira is giving her a blank stare. You know, a cold blank stare. Oh, here we go. Cornell will tie up. And this is Saturday takeover.
Now look at this. Just got her by the arm here. Akira goes behind, rolls around into the headlock. Takedown here. Head scissors. Amy Lynn. Akira kicks out of it. Box in the headlock.
But, you know, the match is going fine now. Oh, nice. But I can guarantee you, this match can take a complete 180 real quickly.
Yes, with either of these women, I know for a fact you are correct there, Chase. For Akira Yukimura, we all know what the home run shot is with Akira Yukimura usually. It's that Dragon's Wrath. It hits, it is usually lights out, and it could, and we've seen it many times, guys. It can hit out of absolutely thin air. The same can be said about Amy Lynn with the last shot. So Haya Jones is back in the booth, and go ahead.
I had to step out to go to the bathroom real quick. What's up with Amy?
Look at her face.
Yeah, I'm seeing that. What is happening?
Do you remember? You remember this because me and you called it. You remember when she was going through that shadow phase?
Yes.
With the whole deal with Revy?
Uh huh.
This is like the shadow of Satan, in a sense, encased her soul. You know, because of how personal this has gotten for her, Millen. You remember the 7-year anniversary, right?
Yes. Yes, I do.
When she, you know, lost to Akira?
Yes.
And I was like,
discus knee.
And here's the thing, Akira Yukimura, someone we've known for, you know, doing these type of looks, you know, which Amy Lynn is doing, is certainly not impressed.
That begs my next question. What happened with Akira?
A lot.
I guess it has to do with this whole new, like, this dynasty thing that she's starting.
You've seen social media.
I've been hit and miss with it, yes.
Her, Envy, Trixie.
I'm sorry, I asked Envy. That's all I need to know.
And here's what scares me. Her, Pom, Trixie, Envy, and if anyone has seen the graphic, and I don't know if you all have. There's another knee. Everyone sees the graphic which Akira posted, right, on her social media. There's yet to be added one more yet to be added. I hope y'all paid attention to that.
Look.
There's one more yet to be added.
Look, they can add whoever the hell they want to add. If it has anything to do with Envy, it can't be good.
Listen, I can't talk stuff about that, you understand?
Yeah.
But it says it all when an empty seat out Akira personally. Look at this! Inside cradle.
Trying to steal it there. And now, oh my god!
Oh!
Sambo slam there from Amy Lynn! Only a one.
The first front slam on your face. Oh, and Akira just popped to the right hand.
Chop.
Come on.
Yeah. Oh my god. Jesus. Jesus. I know about Amy Lynn's Joshi and everything, but there are very little who can match Akira with strikes.
That is true. A scoop and a high angle scoop, son.
Knee! There's a cover, hooks the leg here, does a care, but only gets a two count. Amy Lynn, you know how badly she wanted this match again with Akira. Been pretty much eating away at her. Meanwhile, Akira's been going through her own personal problems that have been changing her in more ways than one. Not just physically, but
you want to know something that's funny about this match to me? And this is the truth. In the past, in the past, we have said over numerous Akira Yukimura matches, what happens off the result, whether she wins or loses. You want to know what's funny about this match?
Yeah.
I actually think the result matters more to what happens to Amy Lynn.
Oh, that's...
Look at them both.
You might have a point there.
I wonder what that... Because here's the thing. You see Amy Lynn like this. And her saying has always been... Everyone who has faced Akira has always changed. You see Amy Lynn to this deep dark side of Sosa too. Which she's brought out tonight. But what happens if that ain't enough to beat Akira? And we've already seen the struggles of the Suicide Girls, you know, this past week. Remember for you worldwide? It's been well noted the past couple of months. Ever since they got back together in December.
Right.
They have not been able to pick up the pieces of the past.
Big vertical suplex. Exactly that, Rick.
Yeah, look at this. Another
snap. Vertical.
There's a cover. There's two. Only a two count. Amy Lynn now trying to ground Akira as much as possible. Trying to keep her on the mat, which is smart. You don't want to give
ahead there.
You don't want to give Akira the time to breathe. Catch your breath. Think of something new.
Amy on the middle rope.
Turns it down to the canvas and drops it straight to the chest. Right now, she is just picking apart Akira.
And she is taking her time a little bit.
Oh my god!
That is a back break.
Knee driven right into the spine, only a two.
Picking her up now.
Something.
Yeah, Kira's in trouble right now. Or so
there we
thought. There's a kick. Oh, here come the kicks.
The combos, the kicks.
Oh no!
Jesus!
A straight shoot kick to the side of the head, and Amy Lynn could be seeing stars right now.
And just like that, the momentum changed and there was a stomp right to the ribs.
As it always does with Akira, it can change just like that.
So deadly with it. We've always said about Akira Yukimura, she might be the deadliest striker in all of core wrestling.
Oh, I don't think
look at that. And this is smart. That is
up the legs of Amy Lynn.
This is right now ingenious wrestling from Akira for a simple reason.
She takes out that leg, she takes out the last shot, the most dangerous maneuver in arsenal.
Same thing she did to someone at Summer's Vacation. But by the way, I wonder what her mood was like waking up this morning.
Shut up! Wasn't happy, to say the least, thank you very much.
Nice to call it the Rising Star title again here in this company.
For now.
Someone says like a kick puppy.
My
Akira's still going throughout me insulting Sahaya right there.
And
that's a hard busting crab.
You get serious for a minute
here. The straight shooter.
the great shooter
of doom.
Shades of the late great landstorm.
He's not dead.
Looking down on us. He's now Emmy Lynn trying to reach for the bottom rope.
But Landstorm's not dead.
Rope break.
Emmy Lynn now.
You can see Akira just pacing back and forth.
She's just waiting. She's stalking her.
That's exactly what she's doing. She's stalking her. Pacing back and forth.
Oh, no.
Oh, oh no.
Wait, no.
Oh, Akira. Oh, right on the neck.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
Chap.
Oh my god! Second time in this match, Jamie Lynn has landed that.
That's a mistake.
But just instantly, in a blink of an eye, Akira Yukimura changes the momentum. Oh, just crowned right in the spine!
Oh my god! One,
two,
two,
the
match is going.
You got her right in the back with that.
And that'll send the shockwave right down to your spine.
Yeah.
That it will.
To your boots. That was a brutal shot right there.
Well, send tingles down your toes. Now,
kick to the face.
Kick right to the head.
Oh, no! Mariatto!
Yeah, stuffs her completely. And now double
stuff missed! Lariat from Emmy Lynn sending Akira to the floor.
Oh, Emmy Lynn has her in her sights. Here
Emmy
comes
Lynn gonna, oh no, thank you! Oh, and just clocks her in the side of the head. Oh. And did you
smart.
See what she did after?
I don't know if that's smart.
I mean, imitations is just a serious form of flattering, but I don't
not
think
to Akira Yukimura, it's not.
I don't think that was quite.
Roll for a neckbreaker!
Got it. And a little slow there. Two.
Two.
No.
Picking up Akira, all making forearm. There's another one. Forearms coming a plenty there.
Oh,
good
kick.
Yeesh.
Now has her in her sights. Ash, a whip head scissors. From Akira Yukimura saying that's it. That's a shooting star press from Brett's rope. The most dangerous rope.
The deadliest rope.
Two.
Two. It is. No, it's not.
Not even from Brett's rope.
Akira now could be looking to finish.
Calling Emmy Lynn to her feet. Oh, but Emmy.
No.
Hey, we'll push up. Super kick miss.
No.
Oh, oh she
no.
blocked the kick.
Oh.
Oh, through the knee. Ultimate mid session.
Stuck on the thing.
Get that the final kick was right in the spine. That was so well she placed that final kick. Oh,
yeah,
Emmy Lynn's
not
getting it. We'll fight back at the neck, kicking away herself.
Emmy Lynn's out. Emmy Lynn's come out with some of the blues.
Super kick, no.
Oh, wait. Oh, woo.
She wants to prove that she has what it takes.
Yeah, absolutely.
Get something going.
That she can beat Akira.
There is a select list of people. Oh, who have ever been able to beat this woman. Emmy Lynn wants to add her name to that very list. The upper echelon of talent that have beaten Akira Yukimura.
So, and for Emmy Lynn, she thinks she kinda needs it, if we're being honest.
Otherwise,
oh my god!
Ah!
Two. No.
ending out on the middle rope.
She's going for it. Oh!
No. Not today.
Awkward landing.
Side out takeover from Akira, and look at Akira just squeezing the head. And Melian able to finally roll her off. Moonsault is a no!
Try to go for that line salt, couldn't get it. And now, GDR!
Yeah!
Right on the back of the
middle of the ring.
One, two, no!
Shade
the former IWGP Intercontinental Champion Hiroki Goto.
Who never won the big one.
Shut up!
And there's chops! And a kick! And the chop!
Oh my god, these strikes from Lynn. Oh!
Whoa!
Oh!
To the leg!
Taking a knee.
Oh!
Now what?
Whoa! Pulled the rope, and Akira went for the kick, and Akira crashes to the floor.
Oh my god! Akira slaughtered out of midair, and now here comes Akira Yukimura!
Didn't
get all of it though.
She got enough of it.
Enough of it, but not all of it.
Amy Lynn is still down. Akira's back to her feet. Is she gonna do it again? She's gonna do it again.
And Amy Lynn just was like, nope, not twice.
That time she got none of it. And now here comes Amy Lynn.
Oh my god!
Suicide tornado. Okay.
Amy Lynn
is playing too much.
Uh-oh.
Nope.
Wait a minute. Oh! Backbreaker! I guess you could hear Akira bouncing off the steps as well. Amy Lynn getting back into the ring. Oh, here comes Amy Lynn! Oh my god! Suicide tornado DDT. And now what?
What?
Whoa!
Oh, no.
Kick to the midsection. Clubbing blow to the back. Oh. There's a kick. There's a chop. There's a nothing. Oh my god!
Impulsed head first.
Jeez.
Oh, good lord.
Bouncing her head right off the solid steel. There is no protection.
And from such a short distance as well.
And that was almost right back into it. I think her shoulder caught it.
Oh, whoa. Oh god, is she caught?
Yeah, she's busted open.
The cut!
She got cut up the right above the left eye! The ring post busted her wide open!
That is not good.
And that won't help it.
Jeez.
I think it was the way, you know, you remember how I said such a short distance?
Yeah.
You cannot defend yourself from being tossed at a steel ring post from such a short distance. You really can't.
You really can't, no. I mean, if somebody wants you face first into that steel post, you're going face first into that steel post.
And there are no gifts in that. That is pure steel, and as Amy Lynn's face demonstrates.
Look, it's supposed to hold the ring up. It's not supposed to be used for a weapon, but Akira used it for just as that.
And this event, it's totally illegal.
Yep.
You're not going to get DQ'd in a night. Redemption rules again! Continuously. Oh my.
Just a straight shoot kick.
That was great.
Oh my! Oh! Oh, okay. Well, one, two, yeah. Oh.
Well, I come back and I see.
I mean,
Amy
just
Lennon
like
leave.
That.
Yep. Jason, welcome back. Yeah. She is.
She's. Oh, she is a bloody.
I've been watching everything from the back, so. I've seen what Amy Lynn is and Akira's new look here.
It's just
Shadow and the Giants.
It's just two women who are going through complete changes. Oh my god! Oh my god!
Right
Jesus.
To the foot.
Not just in ring wise, but life wise.
Yes.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Akira up on the apron there.
Oh no. Oh my god. Oh, good Meteora!
Ow.
Right to the jaw.
And now you can just see the whole complexion of this match has changed 100%. As you can see it, like, kind of a hush from this crowd there. Oh god, they are
spitting knee from Akira!
They are concerned for the health of Amy Lynn here.
I mean, wouldn't you be concerned for the health?
I mean, that's... Oh, my God!
That's a nasty split above the head.
Dragon's kiss on the thinly padded floor. Oh, good God, that was disgusting.
Oh, God.
Oh, forearm. Chop. Oh, now look at this. Striking away. At Akira. Uh-oh. Wait, no. And a chop. And a forearm. Both these women just going at it.
Something's got to give you in a sense, guys.
Oh!
That it does.
But Amy is still getting back to her feet.
Amy will not quit.
No, she
will
not.
The last thing she will do, she will not quit at all.
She wanted this match. She wanted it.
Akira set up the ring post.
Akira getting up close and personal with the ring post there.
Oh, that's twice.
Jeez.
That is what we call a receipt.
I think Amy Lynn might be looking for a bit of Akira's blood here.
I would not doubt it.
Well, you know what they say, an eye for an eye, but in this case, the drop of blood for a drop of blood.
Oh! And we know what an eye for an eye has done for professional wrestling over the past few months, Jesus!
I'd prefer not remember that.
No! But anyways, as we... Back to this... No! Jesus Christ!
Oh,
Amy Lynn has tried to kick Akira over that barricade.
That was disgusting!
Disgusting!
Jesus!
Oh my god!
Christ! On a unicycle.
In between the steel steps! Just kicked her head in! Uh-oh. He's gonna do it again!
Uh-oh, no, good god.
Jeez!
Oh my
god!
Super kick!
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
She was sitting like Akira.
Uh-oh.
Oh, guess what? Return the favor. We got double bleeders.
And thus the blood shall be spilt.
Both women wearing the crimson mask here, and Jesus!
There's the neckbreaker again. There's the one, there's the two, and not a three just yet. Amy, whoa! What a counter!
Nice arm drag.
Japanese arm drag.
Whoa! Fancy stuff.
Japanese arm drag!
Both women going to the Joshi roots in a sense. Oh! First DDT.
Scorpion death drop. Shades of Steve.
Jesus!
Oh, God. One! Two! No!
Nada.
No.
not just yet.
Oh, okay. Amy with the kick. Has her up. Wait a second. Disaster kick!
Right on the jaw.
Oh, okay. Insult to injury! To insult!
Oh!
Whoa! Trying to kick her head off.
Kick to the knee. Oh, God. Oh, stock to the hand. Kick to the back.
Will be a cure rolling onto the apron.
Trying to get some preparation here.
Oh!
No!
Pele kicked.
Boom!
Miss. What the?
What the hell? Oh, no. Regal!
Regal!
What? Dude! No!
Jesus.
Just compress. Just compressing Akira.
Compressing her neck.
Whoa.
Miss.
Oh. The midsection. Oh! Hand. To the back!
That was on the digits.
What the hell? Oh, my God!
Nobody home. Oh, right in the head. And then a torero press.
No, what's the shots missed? Oh, wait, what is this? Oh, my God.
Oh, my, oh, my God. Pump handle.
Amy's long. Two.
No, didn't get it. Didn't get it. Two.
And now I'm trying, possibly trying to rip that arm out of her, out of socket.
Still wrong with that though, the more, when you do these pressure holds, you force the blood to come out the edge, you know, the pressure you're building up.
Uh-huh.
Blood rushes to the head.
Kick! Forearm, got her dazed. Or so we thought. Big chop. Oh. Another big chop. Back elbow. Good Lord. And now the strikes are coming aplenty in this contest. Here comes Akira. Big time scorpion kick.
Akira though with a prone and looking out of it, Amy Lynn. If you saw her, Akira just looked at her, it was like lifting dead weight.
What the hell is she doing?
What the hell is Akira doing? Oh my God! Spanish fly!
What? Two! No!
Shut her up!
And he pulled out a whole out of Spanish fly!
Holy God.
Oh my God!
Whoa! Kick! And now Amy's locked! Kira moves out, but she's not dead!
Yeah!
Suicide tornado DDT!
Holy fuck!
Spike it up!
My God!
Oh!
And
oh no! Right to the head. Let's take a look
okay,
at this.
Okay, so we're gonna take. This is the DDT. Watch this.
Oh my God!
Boom!
Spiking up.
Suicide tornado DDT. And Amy was not done there. Puts her back in the ring. Grabs her by the hair. Slams her face first in the apron. You thought she was done there? Not just yet. There's a knee. Just to follow up.
And.
Yeah. Oh my God!
So.
One, two, no.
Nada.
Akira still has enough in the tank to get the shoulder up. For how much long is the real question? Both women bloody messes as this match still rages on. There's a fireman's carry.
There is no give right now. This could go either way.
It sure seems like it. Wait a minute! Disaster kick!
Wait, well, what's she doing now?
I don't
know. What is she aiming for?
Springboard! Oh! I think she caught her right in the rib cage. And speaking of which,
you catch him in the rib cage, target the ribs.
Again, both. Oh,
she got the knees.
She got him with the feet and the knees.
Oh! I should get a try for it. God!
Oh, that time she got it. Oh!
One, two.
No!
The damage here, though, it's got to be adding up, guys.
There's no way it couldn't be at this point. Inner side.
No.
Kick. What the hell? Disaster!
Disaster kick on the chin!
Right. Oh! Oh, that was an awkward landing.
That was, she burst. Oh, and then she got taken out.
Kira missed her moonsault. Amy Lynn decided to go hit one of her own.
An Amy Lynn hit. Akira missed.
Jolt
breaker! The back breaker.
A jolt breaker sending another shock right up Akira's spine.
Oh, Jesus! Good lord.
Amy Lynn could be set up here, guys. That's the position she wants to be at. Uh-oh.
Whoa.
Wrestling. Quick arm drag.
Roll through. Off the ropes. Drop kick to the ear! Amy barely making it back to her feet. Ah! Chop!
Kick.
Oh, there's a kick. Has her in position. Brings it to the outside. What the hell?
What is this? He's gonna fly!
Get out! Oh,
Jesus!
No! Look at the kissing table!
She hit the announce table on the way down.
Right into the table.
It was disgusting.
That was planned as well.
I would think so. Oh. Amy back from the top. That's where she's grown accustomed to.
Oh,
right to the forehead, right to the cut.
Well, that was right though. Did you see how AJ checked after that shot?
Yeah.
Checked to see if Akira was still conscious, but she is.
Super kick. To her own, stubbornness. Yes, yeah, she is still alive.
One, two, no! Remember, Akira. Go ahead, sir.
I was gonna say, Spiral Bomb does not get the job done.
Nope.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
By the way, we have to
get
it.
More drop.
We have to wonder about Akira's condition, by the way. She has been taking on a heavier schedule as of late. Think back to her walls.
Choke!
No!
She is taking a lot more than we are used to seeing. We've been used to seeing from Akira for like, I think, a good 4 years now. Push back. Akira now on the middle rope. This is not looking good for Amy. Oh!
It's an Akira that's more focused than ever, and with this, she's put out some bangers.
For real, here's the pump handle Samoan slam or whatever, I don't fucking know.
Woo!
Whisper in the wind.
Did not, and it was a truly whisper in the wind because no one heard it. But they're gonna hear this!
Jesus!
Thank God!
One, two, no!
Torturing into a spinning powerbomb, but not putting him in the way.
Torturing tornado bomb did not get it.
Elbow.
Wait.
Akira got my leg again. Akira kicked up off that.
You know what? After this match, they're not
going to
need stitches. They're
going to
need staples after this match.
Absolutely.
Side of the head.
Joey!
Oh,
here we go. It's time, guys. The walk.
And now.
The hook.
Dragon.
The bloodied dragon's kiss.
And
that
one,
two,
one, shoulder up,
not.
Excuse me, what?
And Akira's beside herself.
I would bet.
Ooh, two.
It's rare to even see people ever kick out of that.
Said this to you all truthfully. Amy Lynn is determined here tonight. Big knee! Oh my god!
Oh my god! Oh, she's not done! She's not done! She's not done! She's telling to get
my god
over here! I told you Amy Lynn will not be denied!
She's yelling, fight me!
What
the hell is it?
What
the hell is it? Amy Lynn is not about to return this favor.
She is!
Avalanche Spanish fly from the corner.
One! Two!
No! Shut her up! Shut her up!
Second, first, same as the first.
Oh my god! Lines are up. No arm drag.
No arm drag and whoa, no cutter, nope.
No. Hazard. No. Yeah. Knee!
Oh, nice knee. Kitchen sink knee.
Christ almighty. Uppercut. Super missed. No. Jump breaker!
Perfectly, yeah. We're witnessing a war right here. Can we agree?
Oh my god! I think that's fair to say, yes. Me!
Holy crap.
We're out of nowhere!
And now, whoa! Wait,
that's what I said, Quill!
One, two,
no! Oh my god! Small package!
One, two,
no!
Now the women give it an inch right now.
I wonder what's it gonna take for Ravo to
win.
No. Oh god! Wait, Dragon Sleeper!
Modified.
A modified Dragon Sleeper from Akira to Amy.
And she's got that hook tight, by the way. This and the worst thing about this is the blood from Amy Lynn's head will continue to flow. Looking at maybe a tap out or a pass out.
This has to be it now.
Whoa.
Oh, she went for a shot.
Whoa. Back.
Mitchell!
Mitchell!
One, two.
No!
Still not enough!
And oh my god!
Luckily she managed to control her landing! Still took a knee!
Goodness me!
And then took a full kick in the face. What is Amy?
Swanton! A Swanton bomb from Amy Lynn! That's new
almost won it. I've never seen Amy Lynn hit a swanton.
Same.
Oh my god!
There's that kick, 1, 2, nearly takes her head off, but it doesn't get her the victory!
But Akira can sense the finish. Look at the kicks now.
She's just striking away. Oh my god!
She can sense the finish.
No! That signature Yukimura combo. We saw her brother hit it earlier, and now the same from Akira.
Akira.
Whoa! No!
Gonna go for that kick, and no! Ow. Once again, the whisper in the wind misses. Staggering the punch!
Up! No! Tiger suplex!
One, two!
No! Kicks. Look at this. From Amy. Returning the favor. Slingshot! Damn!
Fucking arrow.
Oh god, she missed the knees. What the hell? Oh!
Shoulder at the corner! That was beautiful!
Good lord! Ah!
Holy shit.
It just won't stop. Double foot stomp missed. Oh,
Lariat just cut her off. And Amy had to roll out to the floor.
And, oh,
are
God.
You kidding me?
It's late in this match, too, an Acai moonsault from Akira. Down her sights. No! Amy Carter!
Amy, cradle shock!
Cradle shock in the middle of the ring! 1, 2,
no.
What a
no.
Akira! Kicks out again! There's that.
Hey,
I don't know.
Oh,
oh god, the elbow.
Vicious elbow.
Oh.
What else can these two do to each other? Well, as soon as I ask it.
Oh!
Arabian press.
Arabian press from Amy Lynn. Telling Akira to get back up. Punch.
Oh, straight shot. Another straight shot. Oh, another straight shot, and
right through the ropes. Is it time?
This is the moment.
Is she gonna do it? No.
Caught.
Tag. Oh no!
Moonsault missed. Did it at the corner?
Goodness me!
Amy and I just knocking Akira down. Ah!
Big
the game!
That could be it. 1, 2.
No!
No!
And it's not it.
Both of these women. Over 40 minutes into this contest.
Oh.
Grandbuster. There's the kick.
Oh my god.
Oh,
again.
Jesus.
Oh, kick.
Dead to the leg. Missed the clothesline.
Oh, blow, no!
One, two, no!
My god!
Oh, wait a minute! German suplex!
That's gonna knock someone in a daze.
Maybe it's not Takeru in her dippies.
My god!
The slingshot Rana set it up! The slingshot poster Rana set it up!
Redemption has been achieved for Amy Lynn here tonight.
Completely out of nowhere.
Only been out of nowhere, but it got the job done.
Look at this, right here. Akira was for sure, she had this match right where she wanted it. She could smell it. But look at this! Freeborn! Into the last shot!
It was the last shot. Which put down the Empress.
Definitely.
A huge win.
Amy Lynn now puts herself on the list of top names of people who have beaten the Empress.
Look at her eyes!
She is.
Safe to say Nilan's in the right mindset. Agreed?
Agreed.
But it has.
This is Destiny's own hubris coming back to bite her in the ass.
She made her own grave. And now she's got to sleep in it.
Good God, can you believe we're only 3 matches into this show?
Yeah, I can!
Thank you. against that? Guys, did you see her just threw something?
Oh.
Wait a minute. Is that?
That's Sierra Knight.
That's Sierra.
That is Sierra Knight.
And we don't know who that is under the mask. That's Malik Brown, the most contender to the Celestial Championship, as that's the matchup right now.
Yeah, but we're set for the Celestial. Wait, Sire, Jason.
Yeah.
You remember a couple of, what was it, 3 weeks ago? We saw a promo from Malik.
Uh-huh.
You know what I was right?
Yeah.
You don't think... Remember how he mentioned the W word?
Yeah.
Is that?
Possibly, and...
Are they?
I would guess. I'm not sure, but...
Well, I like Malik's
Moodle tribute. Yeah, the great Moodle tribute for the Determination Machine here at Redemption. Sai Cooper. With what happened on the 7th of September, when that went out, you understand? Mm-hmm. When we went live for that huge worldwide special. Oh, look at the look. That is channeling Muta right there. The term legend, I know it gets thrown around a lot in this business, you know, in this business we run, and this business we do, but this man right here is that word. He is a legend of this industry. He's been in it for more than a decade. Mm-hmm. He's the current reigning DCA Celestial Champion. He is the Dark Side Shogun. This is Kenshin.
Former TCW Asterix World Champion, first ever TCW Asterix Intercontinental Champion. He is a man that has simply done it all in terms of virtual wrestling status. He's gone all over the world, faced some of the best there have ever been in virtual wrestling. However, he hasn't gone up against Malik Brown.
Reed. Shocking, these two have never even gone up in a match against each other. They're rowdier tonight. We're about to see a dream match, fellas.
Oh boy.
A once in a lifetime opportunity being shown right in front of this crowd here tonight here at Redemption 2020.
And that's what it's all about.
Mm-hmm.
The celestial title of this company.
Here we go.
The bell, and we are underway with this match, which is. Oh my god.
Well, he said he was channeling Muda here tonight, and we meant it.
Yep. No intimidation, though, to Kenshin.
Oh, absolutely not. He is called the Dark God, Dark Side Shogun for a reason. Can't get inside the head of Kenshin. Kenshin making it being known right now that this is only the beginning. Malik's going to have to try something new. He's not going to outpower Kenshin, that is for damn sure.
Oh, not a chance. You ain't going to outpower Kenshin.
Malik Brown is going to try to out-wrestle Kenshin. That'd be a great option.
Try to use his more technical prowess to slow Kenshin down. Oh, wait a second. No, Kenshin, now with the Fujiwara armbar.
Rolls through.
Rolls out of it. Both men just jockeying for position here.
I mean, what makes this so interesting is it's not just the respect factor in this bout. It's just the years these two men have showed on the road.
Yeah. It's now, wait a minute. Pushing Malik off. Malik getting out of there.
And that is an old great Muda tactic. In a sense.
Yep.
Back in the day, in the New Japan days, when a match was not going great Muda's way, he would take a minute on the floor, try to sucker the opponents into making this a wild brawl.
Basically lure them into his playing field.
Right.
And here's the thing.
Oh, look at that.
Oh. Oh, multiple forearms.
We might have just suckered Kenshin in doing just that right now. We got an exchange here. Both men hitting each other with forearms.
Ooh!
Oh, God!
That's smart! Chop the big tree down, dragon screw leg whip!
And here's the thing about this event, Redemption. We have in the past here at Redemption seen Malik go too he's more sadistic. In the past.
Absolutely. I believe it was last Redemption
Exactly, when him and Finn Taylor almost killed each other.
He went to a very dark and bitter place when he went up against Finn Taylor. Could we see that yet again against Kenshin? Oh, wait a minute.
Drunkies.
Whoa!
Nada.
And now Malik, look at this.
Ow!
Knee breaker. Dragon screw again for the third time.
Working on the legs of Kenshin is a very smart move here by Malik Brown.
Because not only do you take away the power and the strength, you take away that boot-to-head technique.
That's right.
Standing senton.
That's Kenshin's bread and butter, the boot-to-head technique.
That's what
won the title.
On both occasions, that's what's won in the title. The one over Jiraiya Badju, and then back at the anniversary show, you remember when... God, that was...
He had to beat Charles, who suddenly just...
Lost his head!
Oh! Whoa, it's bigger than losing your head! There goes Malik!
Yeah, and I'll say this, you know about that title win Kenshin had back at the anniversary show?
Yeah.
I would say that has made Kenshin in the second reign as, you know, Celestial Champion. More determined as a champion in this reign. Because of the way he won it, in a sense. He won it against the guy who won all, you know, right there mentally.
Yeah.
Kenshin likes to earn his wins, not have his opponents beat themselves, in a sense.
It's that honor factor.
Exactly that, Rick. Look at the strength! This.
Stalling! Yes. Butterfly suplex!
Take a beauty!
Stalling!
One, two...
Two! Near fall! Monahan says two.
He just had Malik thinking about it with that butterfly superplex.
Letting all the blood go to the head.
Yep.
Oh!
Now he is in firm control right now.
Oh, God. Stomping on the head. Oh, God.
Youch.
And now Kenshin going to slow this match down a bit as he's got him in a straight jacket hold.
It'd be in Kenshin's best interest to keep this at a slow pace. Try and keep this methodical. Malik by going into the way he's gone tonight might look to keep this, might look to put this on the wild side in a sense.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like fast pace, out of control, speed. Speed and strength is a definite power advantage to Kenshin. Athleticism advantage goes to Malik, but there's the experience edge.
And now he's gonna follow up here. What the hell has he got? Oh, God.
Oh, I know what he's going for. Neckbreaker across the middle rope.
Oh.
And it's a rarity we say this. Malik Brown, very experienced in this contest.
I mean, yeah. Like you said, he's got two decades plus in this environment. Malik, you know.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God!
Drop suplex.
Malik's one of the best in the world, but even he, in this case, falls victim to being, you know, outmatched by experience from Kenshin.
Which is something we usually, you know, never say.
Yeah.
Really,
oh, not again! Jesus! Just dropping Malik on the back of his head twice. There's a two, but still not good enough for a three. Kenshin just taking his absolute time with Malik Brown right now. Not rushing anything.
Just the thing for Kenshin to do.
Slow down on the speed of Malik.
Take your time.
There's no one benefits more from a complete frenzy than Malik.
Yeah.
As he gets out of that straitjacket yet again. Oh, back to the light goes Malik.
Again, this is a smart tactic by Malik. Take out the legs of Kenshin. You take out the boot to head technique.
Just unfortunately getting his head taken off there with the lariat. And now Kenshin has Malik up against the ropes. And, no
money and down. Whoa!
And so, and Kenshin's down.
Kenshin recovering here as Malik's gonna fly!
Slingshot forearm there from Malik Brown. Catching Kenshin right in the face. And now has him hooked. Right, just stomping in his chest.
Jeez.
Malik now in control.
And while it's on the floor here, let's be honest, advantage Malik.
Yeah. I mean, he can pretty much do whatever he wants. There's no disqualification, there's no count out.
And we've seen Malik go to a dark place and stop right there at this effect many times.
Wait a minute.
Oh. I know what he said up. I know what he said up.
No freaking way.
What's he doing?
He's getting the run up!
There's the
run up!
The ultimate great Muna tribute! The stage run Lariato! I've watched videos of Muta hitting that Lariato running down the Tokyo Dome stage.
Yeah, absolutely. That is signature great Muta right there from Malik. As now, Irish whip into the corner. Malik now, look at this! Oh!
Can't spring back out, another tribute move!
Again!
Snapmare.
Going off the rope, there's a forearm straight to the chest!
I think it was more like the jaw.
One, two.
Push two and no.
I think you might be right there, Rick.
And that landed on the chest.
That almost caved in Kenshin's chest.
And now going back to the leg. Back to where he started in the first place. Now I'm gonna take
a phone call real quick, bro. What is this?
Figure four!
Figure four.
Woo!
Locked it in tight. Kenshin now screaming in agony as Malik continues to work over the legs of Kenshin here.
And he turned it sideways. He turned it sideways as well.
Yeah. AJ asking Kenshin if he wants to give it up.
Kenshin will not submit.
Kenshin trying to get a hold of something, or he's got to find a way to get out of this hold. Hitting away the leg. Oh, what a slap!
Uppercut.
Straight into the corner.
Jeez.
And now look at these punches. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. No block. And now Malik returning the favor. Oh, wait, no. And now Kenshin.
No, punch, chop, punch, chop, punch, chop, punch, chop.
Goodness me.
Getting intense.
As in Malik. Up.
Neck breaker.
Down he goes with the neck.
Into the cover.
Cover.
One.
Two. No.
Not
just a two.
Malik is down. Kenshin is in control.
Oh, right to the ribs.
And now look at this. Oh, God. To the chest of Malik.
Try to cave in his... Not only to the chest, but eye to the throat area, you would say.
Uh-huh. And now the Garvin stomp, stomping on every available body part of Malik.
Which you have to respect, in a sense, it's kind of the right move to do.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, God.
Oh.
Sent him down. Kenshin might have landed awkwardly on his back there. Or wait, no, he might have been playing possum! Oh, boom! Kenshin might have been playing possum there! And now he could be setting up!
The boot that he could be in Malik's future here!
No! That's it!
Kick the
Shining! Wizard! Or better yet, Shining Jaguar!
What?
Not yet.
I think calling it a Shining Jaguar is more appropriate.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
And now Malik picking up Kenshin. Michinoku Driver!
Perfectly hit Michinoku Driver.
Two.
No.
Malik now putting Kenshin back into the middle of the ring. God knows what he's got planned here. Oh, wait a minute. Expertly applied by Malik.
Is Kenshin gonna tap?
Malik trying to submit Kenshin. Trying to get the submission victory. We could be just moments away from a new Celestial Champion.
That is
dead center of the ring as well.
Can Kenshin get out of this? Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, my. The power advantage of Kenshin comes to play. Breaking out of the moonwalk.
Oh. Goodness me.
Rocking blows there to Malik by Kenshin.
And you could just see Malik just slowly trying to get back to his feet. And now Kenshin does the snap drag.
Kenshin's starting to feel it yet again. Could be looking to finish. Clothesline. Another clothesline. Ducks the line. And a snap power slam.
Nice combo there from Kenshin. Oh,
oh, Rob.
There you go.
There it is.
Something cutter.
One, two, no!
Not even.
Not just yet. But now Kenshin. What's he looking for here?
Setting something up big here.
Kick to the midsection. Malik fell.
Oh, Malik.
Punches to the head.
Oh,
big forearm.
Oh, out he goes.
Uh-oh. Here it comes. Oh, wait, no. Kenshin, oh, get back
out. That is uppercut.
Oh, my God.
Jeez.
Malik thought he had Kenshin right where he wanted, but Kenshin came popping right back in with that uppercut.
Jeez.
Kenshin throws Malik to the outside.
Oh no.
What the hell has he got planned here?
Kick to the
guy.
Oh my
god. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no.
Oh my god.
Good lord.
That move could end a career.
Yeah.
Oh, that might have just broken Malik's spine. Kenshin out, bringing Malik back to his feet. Another kick. He's looking for another. Wait, what the? Oh my god! Oh my god!
Oh,
one, two,
no!
Couldn't get it just yet, but now Kenshin heading to the top. Monster!
No!
Got the knees.
Knees were up. Malik.
Putting it in the corner. Malik now. Go to the hospital.
And go to the tent.
Go to the fucking tent. Picks up.
I'll lean now with him on the shoulders.
Jaguar Rising.
Jaguar Rising on the jaw.
Jaguar Rising connects. Will this do it?
One, two, no! We saw it with Kenzo and it put Takeru away, but it was not the same with Kenshin. Die, Shiny Jaguar!
Not good.
Malika!
He
didn't. I thought he was gonna go for the Jaguar. Wait a second.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm always going for the jump. What the hell? Reverse Gigaport!
God!
Nicely done!
Where in the world did that even come from? Malik pulling out a reverse Gigaport, continuing the work on the legs of Kenshin. Kenshin is screaming in agony. It could just be a matter of time here.
Never know, but this is an impressively applied hold from Malik Brown.
Kenshin, he can't reach the ropes. He can't reach the ropes, but he can will himself out of it. He can will himself out of the hold.
He may have gotten out, but that did some severe damage to the legs.
Lumai Straw!
One, two, no.
Oh, God.
Oh.
Oh. Ankle clutch! Prawn hole! No!
No.
Couldn't get the job done!
No!
Oh! The Black Rose! One! Two!
No!
No! Everything Malik
Malik has tried and it's still not enough. Oh, God. And now Kenshin.
Oh, my.
Getting a knee straight to the back.
Now what are you doing?
What is Malik thinking of? Malik now telling Kenshin to get back to his feet. What is Malik thinking of here? Oh my God!
Step on top, pick on Hilo!
Oh no! Neither man got the good end of that, but Malik is back up and Malik is fired up.
Kenshin's down though. He's Malik, out of it.
He is out of it. And Malik's got to take full advantage of that.
Uh-oh.
Lining him up.
Ah!
Determination effect!
On the jaw.
One! Two! No!
Again! The will of honor keeps Kenshin fighting.
There can't be much left, though. And Malik has to know that. Because here comes Malik. Oh, my God! Up and down!
Cloverleaf!
That's his Cloverleaf!
High angle as well. All the pressure on the back.
Oh, my God. Look at the way Malik is arched. Kenshin could be moments away from retaining his title! Malik! Oh wait, no! Look at Malik! Look at Malik! Willing himself!
Jimmy! Yes!
Oh my God! What else? What else does either man have to do at this point?
Stop!
Big punch! Women all over! Oh, good lord! And now it's time!
Uh-oh.
For the boot to hang!
Jaguar! They pumped him up with it!
The Jaguar shotgun! And now, Malik!
Double stomp!
To the chest!
This is it!
One!
Jaguar! The shoulder is up!
He got the shoulder up at the last possible second. And now Malik Brainbuster! One! Two!
No! What's he gonna take?
Oh no!
Gonna take the whole armada. Jeez.
Everything that these two have hit, I honestly don't know what either man has to do. Malik, going for that collapse.
No, Malik broke the grip. He broke the grip. I don't know if you saw it. Kenshin broke the grip.
He did. And now he's striking. One, two.
No!
Picks him up!
Wait! Oh, the driver!
God,
one,
two,
two.
No!
You have got to be kidding me. The determination of Malik Brown able to keep him in this.
The absolute fighting honor of Kenshin is keeping him in this as well. But you can see both men, they're absolutely... They can't have much more left.
They may not have much more, but they have something left.
Oh my God, and now we're back to... We're back at point A with the forearms yet again. Both of these men just striking it out.
Oh God!
Oh, that was an open arm palm strike and another one on the jaw, on the chin.
Oh,
Malik, that's just teed off.
He's just going at it. Oh, wait a minute!
Oh,
oh, goodness me!
Jeez!
Kenshin now on Brett's rope. My God!
Straight elbow to the face.
Face!
So that was almost to the throat as well.
Oh no!
God.
Oh, he's gonna go for the spine. He's gonna go straight for that spine.
He's gonna spine him on the pond.
No!
Stop doing moves!
What?
No! No! Shut it up! Shut it up!
What?
And she got the shoulder up. You can see it. He got the shoulder up.
I saw it. I just can't believe it. Goodness.
Oh no!
Calamity Trigger!
Oh.
Is it
here?
Time?
We go. Here we go.
Water. No!
No!
No! Pass him! No! It's
German! With the bridge!
One! Two!
No!
Knee! Oh my God! Look at this on knee!
Knee on the bottom! Oh, you can tell though, it's finally got the pace of this match.
Yeah.
Kinda got to Malik at last.
Frog
splash!
One, two,
no.
Still not over. What will it take?
Malik got him up against the what in the world?
Oh no! What the hell is he thinking?
Oh,
what
no.
What the hell is he thinking? He's thinking of he's thinking of Dragon Suplex! Oh my, no, he's thinking of Hot Mouth!
Malik has him in his sights! Jaguar!
Are you fucking kidding me?
No, I'm not fucking kidding you! That shit is gonna put his head in! Boot to head!
One, two, exit!
Oh my God!
Jesus Christ! Kenshin retains the Celestial title!
Oh my God! What a victory! What an absolute victory for Kenshin!
Oh, God. Wow.
That's literally all you could say in this situation.
What a war.
What a match that was. What a performance by both men.
That was quite simply amazing.
It took literally everything out. Look at this. We gotta look at this again. Here's the half and half from the top. Malik thought he had it there with the Jaguar knee, but gets caught with the boot to head technique. Malik popping back to his feet by some act of God, the fighting spirit, but there's the second boot to head technique. And just to make sure, he put the nail in the coffin. Third boot to head technique. And that was lights out for Malik Brown. Kenshin is still your Celestial Champion.
an absolute classic for the Celestial title here at Redemption.
You aren't kidding. That match lived up to the hype and then some.
And to think that's only, and to think we're not even halfway through this night.
It's still got more to go!
We're not even halfway through this night! Unbelievable.
Oh, that's redemption, man. The only night.
The only night where you get the greatest of fucking wrestling matches and the most violent of fights.
And we just saw both in that one match right there.
Yeah.
Without a
doubt. Holy shit. Congratulations to Kenshin. Still your DCA Celestial Champion. Here's my question. Who next? Well, we actually know who's next for the Dark Side Shogun. Fire Knight One.
Lupin the Third.
A completely different challenge. And that happens on the next takedown after this. That's going to be a really intriguing matchup. But Kenshin, still your Celestial Champion.